Damn it. For a low-level demon, he's pretty effective. Hey, Rainbows!
How did I think that fooling? No one's gonna go anywhere on those things.
Mm-hmm. It's just something pretty for the baby to look at.
It's a good look, Charlie.
Pretty? The minute you see a few colors, you get all excited?
Yeah.
Slanta is Tanta.
Alright, ready to go?
Go where?
Come on, sis!
Come on, where?
Road trip to Vegas. Your turn, Phoebe.
Well, how about you, darling?
Why not?
Slanta is Tanta.
Oh, another doorbell.
Me? Who's it gonna be? George Clooney? Justin Timberlake?
Jason?
You ready to go?
That did not work.
It always works.
Does he get inside the house, though? That's the question.
So I take it you don't want to go out?
I can't, because my cousin came into town.
Don't make a fuss about me. You two just go out and have a good time now.
You two are cousins?
Yes, we are very distant cousins. Mm. And
you need to go take some risks and leave the rest up to luck.
See you later. Hey, Pat, do you want to live here now?
Say, how have you been, Seamus? Long time.
Oh, he knows him.
Don't even try it, Neil. I already hit you with me best shot.
Hit me with your best shot.
Wait. There must be $50,000 there.
60 is more like it. Okay, maybe we should think about quitting while we're ahead.
Piper, I cannot.
The house always wins, Paige.
Something really big is about to happen. We hold on and wait for it.
Remember what he said about bad luck?
Oh, just one more roll. Okay, fine, but we are not betting at all, because I can send Wyatt to college with this. The bigger risks we take, the more luck we have.
Wyatt's college
just
fun.
Watch this.
We're going to lose it all.
Snake eyes.
See? No college for Wyatt.
Snake eyes, that's it. I just figured out a way to find the demon. Stration. Demonstration.
Demonstration.
You know what I mean. Come on.
It's an accent thing, you know, dude?
Okay, what are we doing here? Because I really need to get home.
Look around, tell me what you see.
Lots of couples, and they're kissing, and drinking,
there's a lot of kissing.
Dancing. What I don't see is the point.
What if I told you all these people met over the internet?
All of them.
Right. Wait, so you brought all of these couples together?
They brought themselves together.
He's like Cupid.
My company just made it a little easier for him. I admit, online dating isn't perfect. There are people who use it for all the wrong reasons, but most people are just looking for love. Just like the rest of us.
It's funny how, of all the things in the show to be dated, internet dating is sort of like, it's so commonplace now, you know, Tinder and all that, that it's kind of weird to hear people talk about online dating being so sort of weird thing where people are never going to find any love, you know? Just like 20 years ago. It's probably the place where people meet the most nowadays. I don't know.
Like the rest of us?
You need to get started on that rewrite.
Why don't you write it, dude? You're the expert.
Snake eyes. So what? I don't get it.
Well, Salil is a reptile demon, so we can use them to scry for him.
Did you find the demon?
Well, the vanquishing potion is done, so we're almost there. Do you win the lottery? Ed McMahon show up at your house with a big old check?
Nothing happened.
What? Did you take any risks? Get lucky with that fella.
And no, I did not get lucky. Not that I would want to anyway.
People, we just got lucky.
Perfect. Where is this place? Oh, he's got a whole pot.
Oh no, you soured your luck. Throw the potion!
Oh, lightning. We've got bad luck.
Not so fast, little man.
He's gonna kill him. He killed him. But he was my favorite one. Now what do? We're stuck in the middle of nowhere, and our leprechaun is dead, and our luck has been taken.
Charmed one's my ass. We couldn't even save one leprechaun, let alone all of them. You know, we had luck on our side, we had magic, we should have been up!
Whoop! Oh, we're bad. We have bad luck. Nobody move.
Okay, well, I can't get there right now, so you're gonna have to handle
it
yourself.
Oh, do not drop the baby.
Call an electrician.
Oh, no. Get the baby, Leo. Orbit away.
Take Wyatt out of here.
Yeah.
But
No arguing. Just orb, okay? You were the only one that wasn't cursed with the bad luck. Safe with you.
Wish we knew how to get this thing to make a rainbow.
Okay, a little determination, some positive thinking, a little faith, a little...
What are you doing?
I need you to kill the charmed ones, get them off my back so I can go after more leprechauns.
Let's hear him out.
I've cursed the witches with bad luck.
Yeah?
Which means they're vulnerable.
Easy
now.
Pickings.
It should be easy pickings for you.
That's what I said.
I can guarantee that luck will be on your side.
I got it.
Oh, the whole house is going up. This is going well.
Vanquishing potion done? Well done.
Charm bracelet.
Lucky charms, Paige. It ain't the cereal, but it's the best I can do.
What about...
Did she fall?
What happened?
Oh, I missed the step because I was trying to read my page. How about Saturday night?
Do you think he's Jason?
How do you know for sure he's not another demon?
I don't know. Therein lies the risk.
Right.
I feel lucky already.
Piper! They're invulnerable. Those portraits? No! Well, she already liked her. Get her! Oh no. Not.
They should all be dead.
Yeah.
I never asked for prisoners.
Don't bring him here.
We'll use this witch to lure the others. We can make ourselves enough good luck to make them pay.
I'll just do it myself.
He's killing everybody this episode.
We've got a few charms and he's got who knows how much gold. It's just not gonna cut it.
Unless
we combine our own magic with it.
Go Nairi on Bohalat.
That's the one.
Far out, lady.
Either we leave right now and try to save what's left of us, or we stay and die like the rest.
I vote we stay and die like the rest.
We leave at dusk.
Aye. But look, witches are coming.
We're here because we need your help to save our sister.
And to save you.
Seamus Fitzpatrick was a fool, and look where it got him.
Aye. He was not a fool. He didn't see leprechauns, he saw giants. Please, you've pulled your luck once before. Do it again. Not for us, but for him.
Yeah, for Seamus.
For Seamus.
For Seamus!
Yeah.
For Seamus!
They're easily swayed.
For Seamus!
It's cause Paige has red hair now.
Go away. See, I don't like snakes.
Hello.
What are you guys doing? It's a trap. Yeah, we know.
Can we just orbit really quickly?
The charmed ones.
Here they come.
A leprechaun.
Now, laddies!
Me fortress! Uh-oh. Get out of there.
No!
A very small meteor. Yeah? Do we get any reward for all this? Can we, like, get some money?
Still tied up here, people. I think this belongs to you.
Actually, darling, I think Seamus wants you to keep it.
Aww.
Felt like magic owed me.
And you still feel that way?
I don't.
Doesn't matter what brings a person, only what they leave with.
Nice. I can hang this in the attic. Pop editor!
Well, I've been thinking and I've decided that I want to sell the club.
What?
I mean, being a mother slash charmed one slash businesswoman is just one slash way too many. Something's gotta give.
Well, what about all the famous people we get here?
I mean, I've been stretched pretty thin lately, and I think we're both feeling the strain.
That's why I asked the elders for paternity leave.
Ooh. Huh?
They spent time with Wyatt and realized how important he is.
Aww.
Decided to break the rules for him.
Honey, I don't think I can let you do this.
Piper, it's one thing I don't want to argue about, okay?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Pat Benatar.
You're a heartbreaker, dreammaker, love-taker, don't you mess around with
me. Ooh, nice date wear.
Here on business?
Is he?
Actually, no.
Is he the guy?
I'm meeting someone.
Really? Weird. Me too.
I know. You're meeting me.
It was him. Poetry guy.
I'm Cyrano 73.
Did he know she was Cinderella 29?
I just knew you'd never go out with me if I asked you straight, right?
That's not necessarily
right?
True.
Right.
So, I had to find a way to see if you were interested in me without putting any pressure on you.
Jason, I don't know.
I'm not asking you to marry me. I just want to buy you a drink.
Martini, dirty.
A couple of things. I just want to... Piper said at the end that she was thinking of, you know, selling P3 because she'd been stretched thin with the baby and all that stuff. But then just after that, Leo told her that he was getting a like paternity leave from the elders so he'd be able to be around more for the baby. So I don't know if that means that P3 will go away or not. At the moment, I'm still thinking that she's made a decision to do that with P3, and he's made the decision to take a little break from his other charges, which, look, let's face it, his other charges barely ever make a dent. We never really even think about them. You know, occasionally he'll get like a little, ooh, somebody needs me, but, and occasionally when he's not in an episode or in a few scenes, we can, you know, write it away as he's with somebody taking care of other people, but it's not really, him not being there doesn't really affect the story at all. It's not a big change for the audience. It's the same with whether Paige has a job or not. Like, when she had the job as a social worker, but she could still have episodes like this, and occasionally I'd be asking, hey, don't any of these people go to their jobs? You know, because they always seem to be around the house or doing things, but that's what I mean, like, small changes don't really change the story, which is a good thing. The baby being born does... The show does feel like it's got a fresh start. I feel like we got rid of Cole, then the baby was born. Now Phoebe has potentially a new boyfriend, potentially getting rid of P3. A lot of little changes are happening right now, instead of at the start of a season where you would expect them to normally happen, or the end of a season. So I'm curious what kind of vision they have for the show and how they're restructuring it piece by piece and how that fits into the rest of it. Anyway, that's got nothing to do with leprechauns. The leprechauns in this episode were funny. I was not looking forward to seeing them. but they were fine, you know? I just went with it. I went with the flow. I went over the rainbow, you know, with them. And I just enjoyed it for what it was. Kind of goofy, you know? As long as you play along with it, it's just fine. The lucky stuff, they went to Vegas, or something like it. It's exactly what I was suggesting they do. But we had enough in this little tiny stack of chips for Wyatt's college fund. Damn it. That's a lot of money we threw away on Snake Eyes. Of course we couldn't keep all that money. They would have got us some way, you know, with personal gain, probably, if we had kept on all that money. I wonder after this episode, will Phoebe and Jason officially be a couple? My rule is nobody's officially a couple until they get inside the house. If you're standing at that door, you're not officially a couple. You have to get inside the house. It's the sacred line. Dan was always at the doorstop. The back door, the front door, the window. He found it very difficult to get into the house. And it was kind of a metaphor for the relationship that he had with Piper. Now, are there exceptions? Sure. Was Paige and some random guy on the sofa at the start of one episode? Sure. You know, there's plenty of exceptions. But for anybody long term, we'll see. We'll see if Jason gets inside the house. Or, hey, we need We need an apartment for him, right? We need his apartment. Just don't buy anything near Koi Tower. That's what I'll suggest, Jason. And he still needs to work. I still need to get used to him. He's a different character. He has a lot of qualities that Cole had. Similar looking, similar height. But he is quite different personality-wise. I have to see. And I guess, you know, the creators need to see if there's proper chemistry between these two. And as ever, Paige is still single and free, and that's the way it should be. We don't need all three of them. Hey, maybe the show ends when all three of them get married, but for now, it's good the way it is. It's good the way it is. And we had Pat Benatar singing a song that I sort of vaguely recognized. It's from the 70s. It's not one of the hits I knew. You know? I was really hoping for Love is a Battlefield, or even Hit Me With Your Best Shot. They mentioned that like twice. What else do I know from her? Just looking at her discography. We Belong. So yeah, I would have known three of them really well. But hey, at least she didn't sing like something from her 2003 repertoire. The baby situation may be explained away every episode with this person's looking after them, this person's babysitting, this person's doing that. Whoever's not on the scene is babysitting the baby. It's only like Leo's a great person to have, because the three of them can go on missions to get demons. Leo can always be just back babysitting, because Leo never really, he's not in the field as much as those three. So that solves the baby issue that the show could potentially have. But we'll see where that goes to. Or we could just get a nanny. A live-in nanny. A magical nanny. I know weren't we interviewing for that position? Maybe Jason can take care of it. Maybe we can get Dan to come back and take care of the child while we're off having fun on fun adventures. We can get Daryl Buddy in. You know, he doesn't need to be in the episode. We can just say, yeah, Daryl's taking care of him. For some reason. Doesn't Daryl have a family? Yeah, but he, you know, he just volunteered. I'm kind of glad the elders rejected it, because having the baby up with the elders doesn't feel right. It doesn't feel normal or natural, or it feels wrong on a lot of levels, you know? It almost feels like the baby is dead and not really existing in the world if it was just staying up there, just being a magical baby. Anyway, yeah. The Leprechaun episode was a fun affair. We progress the story with Phoebe and Jason. We sorted through some parenting stuff with Piper and Leo. And we were potentially getting rid of P3. So, looking forward to next episode. It's called Cat House. Oh geez, cats. Hey, maybe Kit will be in the next episode. I haven't seen Kit in forever. So come back for that next time. And, yeah, I'll see you then.